Hey guys, this is Josh Farley back with another video. In this video, I actually want to do a update on the return that I'm actually going to be doing or hoping to be doing, you know, once Waveform actually gets back to me. So if you guys didn't watch my other video, I have that video on my channel, so check it out. I go into detail about why I'm going to be returning the Waveform 4x4 antenna, or trying to get it in exchange, you know, for the same one. So long story short, the cable connector actually broke off when I tried to move it. I tried to move it up in the attic to try to get better, you know, more reliable upload speeds and ping and download and all that. So I was just messing with it, you know, and I didn't, you know, break it on, you know, I didn't do anything to it, you know, myself. I just, you know, moved a little bit, and the connector came off, you know, it popped off. So I actually came on Waveform's website. It's Easter today, so they're not going to be available today. So I started looking around for warranty and limitation, you know, information, you know, and I found this article here on their website. So it actually says down here, it says after 90 days we may replace products with refurbished products. I'm hoping that that's not the case. And it actually says, I'm trying to see where it said 3 years. Oh, actually right here, sorry, duh. It actually says right under the warranty limitation and liability, it says Waveform proudly warranties, all of our antennas and RF components, for 3 years against any workmanship or material defects. So, if they don't want to replace this, you know, they don't want to exchange this and send me a new one out, you know, I'm going to be very upset. You know, I'm going to be very mad, because I haven't even had this thing a year, and the connector popped off, you know, without me even doing anything to it. The only thing I was doing was moving it, and, you know, a connector should not come off, you know, if you're going to move it, and then reconnect it to the gateway. You know, that just shouldn't happen. So I didn't, you know, pull on it or anything. You know, I'm sure they're going to probably ask me that. But I told them in the email, you know, I was like, look, you know, I just moved it, you know, in my attic. I was trying to get better speeds. You know, I moved in a few places, you know, to try to get better upload and download speeds and stuff. Which I did, you know, I just did that, and, you know, it popped off, and I tried to get it back on, in my other video. I have a video on my channel about it, goes more into detail. I tried to get it back on, you know, with my hands, and then that didn't work. So I tried to get it back on with a wrench, and that also didn't work. So, you know, I'm hoping that they're gonna stand behind this, because, I paid $400 for that antenna. So I really don't feel like paying $400 again, you know, basically $800 for two antennas. So, you know, it's not my problem, you know, it's not my problem. I didn't do anything to it. I wasn't, you know, being reckless or anything with it. You know, sometimes I can get mad, you know, with stuff, but I wasn't, you know, getting mad or anything. You know, I got mad when I couldn't get it back on. You know, I'll give you that. You know, I did get frustrated with that when I couldn't get it back on. But other than that, you know, I didn't do anything to it. I tried to, you know, move it, and it just, you know, it just popped off, you know, when I tried to screw it back onto the gateway, you know, my third-party gateway, the Chester Cheetah version 2. You know, I tried to, you know, turn it back on there, and it just popped off. You know, I tried to screw it back on there, and it just popped off, and I was like, oh, well, okay. And then I tried to put it back on, and, you know, that was that. So I was like, you know, well, I guess I'll have to contact them. So I, you know, first thing I did, I went to Amazon, and I kind of was expecting it. You know, they told me that there's not really anything they can do because it's past the return, you know, warranty from Amazon. So I was like, yeah, of course. So I just, you know, exited out of the chat with them because there wasn't anything I could do there. So then I went with Waveform, you know, and then I thought, you know, well, it's Easter, so they're probably not going to answer. And sure enough, you know, they didn't answer. You know, the chat's not available, and I tried calling and they weren't available. So, you know, I emailed them, so I'm going to wait for an email tomorrow. What I might actually do is I might actually just chat with them tomorrow, on Monday, you know, and, you know, get it faster, you know, get it, you know, resolved faster, And see what they say, because, you know, if it's saying right here, you know, like I said, under this, if it's saying waveform proudly warrants all of our antennas and RF connect components for 3 years against any workmanship or material defects, you know, they'll be able to see when I bought it, you know, so it's not even a year old yet, so parts should not be breaking off of it, you know, in that short amount of time. So I don't know, you know, if anybody else has had problems with waveform like this, you know, but definitely let me know, you know, down below in the comments if you have. I'm not bashing them or anything, you know, I get really good speeds with them, you know, with the antenna, you know, the waveform 4x4 antenna in the attic, but I shouldn't, you know, have a problem with the connector breaking off. That's the thing. That's not a good thing. You know, it could have just been a lemon, you know, but I don't know. I wasn't rough with it or anything. You know, I just tried to plug it back into the gateway, and it just popped off, and I was like, wow, you know, oh, okay. You know, so I don't know. I mean, I'm hoping, you know, that they'll stand behind their work, because I did show them pictures, that I tried to, you know, put it back on with a wrench. So I'm hoping that they don't think, you know, oh, well, he messed with it or something, which is not the case. So if they think that, you know, and they, you know, don't want to stand behind their warranty or whatever, you know, I'm going to be like, well, you know, I'm not going to be doing business with you guys anymore. You know, I'm not getting to that point yet. But if they do, if they don't want to give me a replacement and a new replacement, I don't want a refurbished replacement. I want a new replacement. I'm going to be sure to tell them that. I don't want anything refurbished, or used or something like that, because I'll tell, you know, I can tell if it's refurbished or used, you know, because, you know, I'm not going to go with that. You know, I'll tell them, no, send me out a new one, you know, so I make sure that this doesn't happen again. You know, or if it does happen again, you know, I'll still have a new warranty on it. So, you know, if it happens again, though, if I get a new one and then it happens again, I'm just going to, you know, I'm just going to tell them I want a refund and I'm not, you know, doing business with them anymore. Because there's just no reason for that, for a connector to pop off like that. And like I showed you guys in the video, it actually looks like they are glued together. So that's not really, you know, that's not really professional either. I mean, how is that thing going to last out in the weather? I'm thinking about that now. You know, I have mine up in the attic, so it's not going to, you know, really matter, you know, with that. But if I move it around, you know, it seems that popped off. So I'm thinking to myself, how is that going to act out in the weather? You know, rain, wind, you know, stuff like that, hail, snow, you know, just bad weather in general. So I'm thinking to myself, if you only super glue them, you know, that's kind of, you know, that's kind of cheap in my opinion. You know, for a $400 antenna, they shouldn't be super glued, you know, like that, or weather glued or whatever. I don't know, guys, you know, I'm just disappointed in this. You know, it's an Easter Sunday, you know, and I'm disappointed in this. You know, I have to go back to using the, gateway how it was, and my speeds are definitely a lot lower, with the default gateway, with the, Chester Cheetah, version 2 connected with just this internal antennas, I only get around like 400 for download. You know, some people will be like, oh, that's not bad at all. No, it's not. But I noticed the speed difference, because with the waveform antenna, I get like over 500 to 600, almost 700, on the download. So it's definitely noticeable. But hopefully I won't have to deal with it much longer. You know, hopefully they'll get it, you know, resolved, you know, if they stand behind their 3-year warranty. You know, like I said, I haven't even had this thing a year yet. I've only had it a couple of months. So, if they don't stand behind their 3-year warranty and they act like I broke it or something, you know, I'm definitely going to be, you know, mad, and I'm definitely going to be telling them, you know, well, you know, you can just give me a refund or whatever, you know, or something like that. And I'll just, you know, use the gateway as it is, you know, without an antenna. You know, I'll just tell them that I won't recommend them to anybody or anything. So hopefully they will stand behind it, because I don't want to have to do that. But if I do,
You know, it's definitely not going to be good because I'm going to put them out, you know, on my YouTube channel and let everybody know, you know, how they operate, you know, with a place of business. So hopefully I don't have to do that. You know, I'm getting ahead of myself. I'm trying to jump in the gun here. But, you know, if I do have to do that, I'm just letting you guys know that it won't be good, you know, for them, because I'll definitely badmouth them on YouTube. So, you know, and to anybody I can. So, so we'll see. You know, I'm not gonna, you know, like I said, I'm getting, you know, a little bit angry here, but I am angry. I have a right to be, you know, when it comes to this, because I just don't, you know, think that that should have happened. You know, it just shouldn't have popped off like that. You know, it shouldn't, you know, something that's $400 should not break like that. You know, and I'm going to tell them that, you know, when I do talk to them, I'm going to tell them, you know, that shouldn't happen. You know, I'm going to ask them, I'm going to say, you know, well, you know, if I put this outside, you know, I'll tell them it was up in my attic. It wasn't even outside in the elements. You know, it's hot up there somewhat, but I have fans and windows open. So it's not as hot as it is actually outside. But, you know, I feel like telling them, you know, if I put that outside, and that popped off, you know, that could be a safety reason, a safety concern as well. You know, and I really don't want to use it that way anyway, even if I could get it fixed, you know, even if I could get it back on, you know, using a wrench, because I don't feel safe using it that way, because it's not supposed to happen. It's not supposed to come off like that. So it could be a, you know, an electrical hazard, basically, you know, because it's connected to the Chester Cheetah, which is electric. So, you know, it's basically like an electrical hazard. So, so anyway, guys, you know, that's basically the video. You know, like I said, I just figured, you know, I would get this video out there and let you guys know, about the warranty and limitation, of these. You know, I figured that they had to have some kind of warranty on the product itself. You know, either a year or so. So I haven't had it a year. So it's 3 years. So if they don't stand behind it, you know, like I said, I'm not going to be happy. So, we're going to see what happens. You know, I'll let you know. I'll probably let you guys know. I'll give an updated video probably tomorrow, whenever they reach out to me, but I'm probably not going to be doing any speed tests, you know, because until I get the waveform antenna, you know, waveform 4x4 antenna back, you know, set up how I had it. So I'm not going to probably be doing any speed tests because there's not really any sense, because I don't really have it set up how I want it right now. So anyway, yeah, that's basically the video, guys. Like I said, I just wanted to get this video out there, and if you guys like this video, please like and subscribe, and until next time, guys.